initially we discussed with a lot of different companies various options as to how we would do the install, and Cruden's come out with a really good proposal. I was quite keen anyway to go with a local company because certainly a year ago there were less biomass companies around and was less known about it. We've got 9 holiday, 5-star holiday cottages, and when people come and stay in our holiday cottages, they expect luxury, 5-star luxury, so they expect a bit more heat than they might, or they use a bit more heat than they might use at home. They want to be very cosy, and doesn't matter what time of the year that is, they expect it to be warm. So our heating bills can be quite high. Previously, our gas bill, our LPG gas bill, was over £25,000 every year, so it was expensive. Since switching over to biomass, we've saved about £15,000 a year just on our gas bill, so there's a big advantage there. When it comes to the solar PV, we'd expect to save about £6,500. We've had a year of biomass, so I can actually give hard figures on that, but the solar PV has obviously just gone in recently, so we're expecting about £6,500. So our payback on the biomass is about 5 years. There's also a major carbon reduction. Over 60 tonnes of carbon we've saved just on the biomass side. It's probably going to be the total project will be just under 100 tonnes of carbon saved every year by switching onto biomass and solar PV. So there's a big carbon saving there. The carbon that we do burn using biomass, using wood, that carbon was already taken in over time as those trees were growing. So as the carbon's then burnt, it's just carbon that was originally taken in by those trees. It's now being released. So as long as those trees are replaced, the whole thing remains very sustainable, and effectively means that our heating and hot water side of things keep us carbon neutral.